In here, and the poor thing has just been crying her eyes out this whole time. Dawn over there is such a huge fan, so say hello to Dawn.
Hi, Dawn.
What's up, Dawn?
Nice shirt. Oh, that's a rare shirt you got there. That's dope.
Yeah, that is a very cool shirt. Very cool indeed. So how was the show last night? You just played Irving Plaza here.
That place went off. That was good. It's nice to get back in the old, like, smaller clubs and really just... Feel the sweat, feel the heat, it was good.
That's what you're doing with this tour. You've been playing huge venues, now you're playing smaller ones, bringing it to, like, the hardcore fans, right?
Yeah.
A different vibe, obviously?
Yeah, it's just much more immediate, you know? I mean, it's like when you're... It's more of a participatory thing when everyone's, you know, all that close together, whereas when it's seats and a big outdoor place, it's more like people are just watching.
Right.
But they're much more involved when they're a small place like that.
Everybody's a part of the show, right?
Definitely.
Did you get a chance to preview any of the sound system material before a live audience? Do you generally do that with new stuff that you're going to record?
This time around, we didn't. We were just rehearsing it a lot. We built our own studio so we could just practice a lot at whatever was... We could tell what was going to be rocking live just by if we were rocking hard to it. So since we rehearsed it for so long that we knew it was going to be a good album to play the songs live.
Yeah, and it's an amazing, amazing album. I want to talk a little bit more about it, but right now we got to get back into the countdown. Limp Bizkit, you big fans of the Bizkit?
Yeah, those friends of ours.
Yeah, they're a nice bunch of guys. They are here with Method Man at number 4 today in Together Now. Limp Bizkit in Together Now with Method Man, number 4. Now I'm still here with Nick and Esther from 311. I want to check out a little bit of Come Original, which has been on TRL a few times. I don't know if you knew that. But let's get this up on the monitor here. Right on. Now, tell us about the making of this video. This looks like just like this massive party that you got dropped in the middle of.
Yeah, it's skaters and whatnot.
In LA.
It's a high energy song, so we wanted to have like skaters and dancers and just make it, you know, try and capture some energy with like how we're playing live. And that wall of speakers is like 4 semi loads full of speakers, and they were working. So
really?
The bass was just booming that day.
Blowing the hell out of the dancers and skaters and whatnot. Now, whose idea was this? Was it the director coming to you with this?
Yeah, Kevin Chris Lake came up with the concept.
Now, how do you, how have you think
on the board?
Oh, man, don't you wish. Now, how's your sound changed since Transistor? You took a little bit longer with this album, putting it all together.
It's more of a rock album. Transistor is more like a stony, sort of trippy, dub kind of experience. And this is more of a hard, fast, short songs.
It's an amazing, amazing album. Flush the Prozac down the toilet and go pick up Sound System. It's an amazing, amazing album. Make you very happy. Do you want to, while you got the floor, do you want to plead for Come Original to come back onto TRL? You've got their attention now.
Vote for it because we wrote it ourselves, you know. We produce our own stuff.
Yeah, it's rare. It's rare on this show, let's just say. It's an amazing video, an amazing band. Super nice guys. Thank you so much for stopping by. Nick and Essen, 311. Go get Sound System. Let's continue with